old savior. Have you heard of his perfect love? Have you heard of the one in heaven? Have you heard how he gave his son? 'Cause I have found this love. I believe in the sun. Show me your way. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you will always be. Nothing will ever change that. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you will always be. And nothing will ever change that. I believe in the one called Savior. I believe he's the risen one. I believe that I'll live forever. I believe that my king will come. 'Cause I have found this love. I believe in the sun. Show me.
Happy. Hey, SkyKids, thank you for joining us online. We are so excited to be with you guys today. And we are in our third week of looking at the heart, and what is in our heart overflows into our lives. So let's get ready to watch the story. Let's lean in and listen well today. Let's watch together.
Out of all the people in the Bible, our boy David, who grew up to be king, is one of the most famous. We have stories from every part of his life. But before his time, we follow the prophet Samuel. A part of Samuel's job was to hear from God and pass on messages to the Israelite elders and people. The elders and people of Israel started to get unhappy and suggested that a king be appointed. Samuel went to God and asked him what to do. The Lord responded by saying, "If this is what they want, I'm happy with it. But warn them, it may not be everything they expect." So Samuel did exactly that. He explained that a king would likely take all the sons and turn them into an army, demand the very best of the land, sheep, and cattle. He told them it's not going to be the answer they think it is. But the people disagreed with this and insisted on a king. So Saul became king. Not long after he began to reign, things began to go wrong. Saul deliberately disobeyed God's instructions and ignored Samuel. With this in mind, it came time for a new king to be appointed. And here comes our David. This was the very man that God selected to become the next king of Israel. God saw something in David that others may not have seen. God looked past his appearance and found a man who loved God, a man who looked after his heart. Samuel found it hard to believe that he could be king, but God saw David's heart. He was anointed and in time ended up in the courts of King Saul, playing his harp, carrying the peace of God with him to soothe Saul's troubled mind. When David stood before Goliath, he had a peace and an assurance that God was with him. There was a confidence that he couldn't fail with God on his side, and he was. For many years, the jealousy of King Saul drove him to hunt David down and attempt to get rid of him. Even though this meant he had to live in caves, in mountains, and live in constant fear, he never allowed it to harden his heart. After the death of King Saul, he became king, but all wasn't wonderful. There were horrible mistakes that caused him to repent before God, but amazing moments of celebrating with all his people. Although he wasn't perfect, David loved God and did his utmost to maintain that love for him. It's amazing that with God at the front and center of his life, he did great things for God. He won big battles, saved the nation of Israel, and knew what it was to worship with everything. He wrote a lot of the Psalms in the Bible, you know. Maybe we too could be known by God as one who is after God's own heart. Maybe we could pursue relationship with God the way David did and love him with all our hearts.
Wow, that was an awesome story about how David became king. So now we're going to look at three points that's going to help us remember what we've learned in today's story. So point number one is a book about me, or a book about you. If somebody had to write a book about your life, what would the theme be? And what would the book be all about? Is it a book about how God has changed your life, how a friend was helped by another friend, how you serve God, how you honor God? What is the theme of your life? In Psalm 45, David writes about how his heart overflows with a good theme and how his tongue is like a pen of a ready writer. Whatever is in our hearts is going to overflow into our lives. What is the story that we are going to tell with our words and the way that we live? Think about all the amazing things that God has already done for you in your life. I would want my story to be about goodness, about joy and love and adventure. And God wants us to know that whatever goes on into our hearts is the thing that will be overflowing. So let's think about that. Whatever overflows out of our hearts will flow into every part of our lives. Point number two is an overflowing heart. We had one rule for my brother in our house. He was not allowed to fill up the water jug when it got empty, because what he used to do was just put the jug in the basin, open the tap, and walk away and get distracted with something else. And every single time, the jug would overflow with water and the water was on the floor and everywhere. So, do you guys think if we put water in a jug that orange juice is going to overflow? No, and that's the same with our hearts. Whatever we fill our hearts up with is what will overflow into our lives. Now, some people store up bitterness and hate and jealousy and anger and offense. And those kinds of things we must be very careful of, because what we store in our heart, what we store up there, those are the things that are going to come out. And the Bible says that we can store up the good things of God in our hearts. The good things, like His love, His joy, patience, all those things we can store up in our hearts, and that will be the thing that overflows into our lives. And point number three is have a heart after God. David, that wrote the Psalms, was known as the man after God's own heart. Now, he was just an ordinary guy. He was not a perfect guy. He made lots of mistakes and he sinned many times in his life. But David had a strong faith in God. He knew how to trust God. And he was the shepherd boy that defeated the giant Goliath. He knew how to trust God going into a scary battle. And David loved God's word. He meditated on it. He worshiped God through his whole life. And he honored God with his life. He thanked God for everything that he's done for him. Now, how can we have a heart after God like David? We can grow our faith every day. We can spend time in God's word, learn the truth, fill our hearts with good things, and we can know that God loves us and that we can trust Him in every situation that we face, just like David. Whatever we store up in our hearts, the good things, God's word, His truth, will overflow into every part of our lives. Now, guys, we had the best time ever, and I hope that you also learned a lot, just like me. Thank you for joining us online. Next up, we're gonna have our memory verse, so have lots of fun. I know that you guys would know it by now, but because it's the third time that we learned it, but I hope that you still have fun, and then we'll see you again next week. Bye.